Now, on this short video, I will talk about the three control in front of the boiler. Now, let's say you take a look. The first one I want to take a look is the operating limit pressure switch. I'm going to close in here. Okay. Now, in this one, the first one you look for is in here. The word different is a subtractive. So it works differently between the addition one and the subtractive one. The one operating limit we have is a subtractive one. So what you mean by subtractive is the mainspring, you see the mainspring in here? That is the pressure you set for the boiler to operate. And then on the small spring on the left, right in here, this one is your differential. So if the switch is subtractive, that means the big spring, the main is set in here. So right now it's at 125 PSI. Now, and then the differential is 10 PSI. So since this one is subtractive, that means the boiler will kick out, just shut off automatically when it reaches the setting in here, 125 PSI. Now, and then after boiler shut off, somebody gonna use the steam, the steam drum pressure gonna drop. When it drop to 125 subtract 10 PSI, will be 115 PSI, and the boiler will automatically start up. So that is what the subtractive mean. Okay. Now again, the big spring is the one that cut out the boiler, and the cut in is a big spring minus the differential that is a cut in. So in this case, cut in 125, the cut in pressure is 125 minus 10 is 115. Okay, so that's the operating switch. Now, so the next one on top of there, it is called a high limit pressure cutout. Now, this particular one, they have a reset button there. You see the green one there? That is a reset button. So anytime you see a reset button, that is a limit switch, just a safety switch. So in this case in here, this one will cut out the boiler at the predetermined pressure. Let's say zoom in there, see what it is. So this one pretty much set around 130 or so, a little bit higher than the operating switch. Okay, now, so it ordinary, the operating switch will turn on and turn off the boiler. But somehow, if this switch does not work, suppose 125, it go all the way to 130, 135, something like that. Whatever this one set at, this switch is supposed to cut it out. That is a safety switch. Now, so if this, your operation switch does not work, and the high limit control does not work, the only thing that protect you is the safety valve, which is set higher than the high limit. Okay, now let's say we'll go to take a look the safety valve. Okay, this one is the safety valve. So the way it's set up, it's like this. The safety valve is set at 150 PSI. And then we'll take a look at the high limit. So the high limit here, probably set 130, and then your operating limit, set 125, okay? So what? A few steps. Now, let's say we take a look at the bottom one. The bottom one is called modulating control. So the modulating control is an automatic control, a fine control, the fine weight. Now let's take, we take a look at on the side of the boiler, that there is now you see in here, you can put put the boiler on a manual control or automatic control. If you put this on automatic control, that means the modulating control will take over. So that is the modulating control there, right at the bottom there. So that's the modulating control. Okay. Now, if you, on the other hand, if you put this one on manual, just like right now it's on manual, so that modulating control have no effect at all. So in this case, we put it on manual. The knob on the left, this knob is a manual frame control. This is the one that control the firing way. You can turn it a little bit higher. So when you turn it, make sure you don't just turn it like this. You turn it a touch at a time. So give time to adjust. Okay. So now, when you start up the boiler, make sure this switch is on manual and the knob is way at the zero position.